So I'm going to start off with a look at what's happening in the mid to upper levels of the atmosphere, because this is playing a huge role in influencing Ada, how Ada is organizing and evolving in the next couple hours. But basically, even throughout yesterday, this area of dry air has been wrapping around and entering towards the center of Ada. And so I definitely think that was one of the factors why Ada didn't strengthen to a Category 1 hurricane as it was approaching the Keys. Now, there's still dry air working its way into Ada, so wherever you see the greens bubbling up, that's where those rain bands are popping up that Lisette just showed you on real-time Doppler. But there's going to be breaks in between because there's still that dry air working its way in the mid and upper levels of the atmosphere of Ada. There's also that upper level low that also kept Ada from further strengthening and causing wind shear. I'll get to wind shear in a second, but I want to show you this atmospheric moisture forecast. The bulk, the core of the moisture with Ada is really big. It's a big shield, but it does move offshore into south, into the southern Gulf of Mexico. And then, you know what? By midweek, we're honestly not going to see dry conditions because that moisture tail looks like it's going to set up for much of the Sunshine State, even though Ada is still going to be over the Gulf of Mexico. Now let's talk about the wind shear forecast. So it's been under some disruptive wind shear. Now that wind shear is going to lighten up when it gets into this area of the southern Gulf of Mexico. And take a look at what happens on the forecast cone. This is when Ada has a chance to upgrade to a Category 1 hurricane and also when it turns northward. But then the wind shear becomes more intense and it downgrades to a tropical storm. Still, as Lisette mentioned, all of Florida still has to keep a watchful eye on Ada through the rest of the week. Here's a look at our future weather model. So these heavy rain bands are still going to set up, but they're going to push slowly more towards the west. So I think by 7 a.m. Upper Keys, you're going to get some heavy rainfall. But you know what? It starts to clear out by 3 p.m. Doesn't look too bad out there. Just there's still going to be these quick moving passing showers as we continue on through Tuesday, because it will still remain quite on the windy side. And speaking of wind, those gusts today, 35 to 45 miles per hour. The worst of it, of course, this morning, and then the winds start to drop off throughout the rest of today.